is semifinal Sunday here in Richmond at the Virginia 529 College Savings Plan CAA Men's Basketball Championship as the number one seeded Drexel Dragons get set to take on the fourth seeded Old Dominion Monarchs.
Hopefully all around the basket, but yesterday they really shot it well from the three, and Chris Fouch got a big part of that.
Nobody on Macedet inside in a 4-0 Drexel lead to be going to the NCAAs. Fouch again wide open. This time he drains it.
Well, this season, I think Macedet and Damian Lee, their tremendous freshman, made a big difference.
And Sammy Givens,
that's your team.
Really of both teams. Back, got it.
That defense, he's one of their three-point shooters who consistently score from the perimeter. He had five rebounds yesterday as well, coming off the bench.
Chris Fouch came wide open again. Ice cold shooting and still. Just a nine-point game. Fouch. Got it. His third three of the first half. Baysmore. There you go. 2 minutes without a field goal. That's how the lead is leaked away. Cooper. Oh, my.
Great thing in college basketball. How do you create it? And how do you stop it? Sometimes a shot like that can get you going.
Macedet exploding down the lane, and that stops the 7-0 run for the last 25 games. Macedet in traffic, how about that?
Point guard just a year ago, and at 6'4 when you're a freshman, making that conversion is not easy.
That's a big shot from Lee from down the corner. That's right from the top. Oh! On the pass, this was a great way to defend Drexel. Now they've got a three-point shooter. Fouch. And he's gone cold after a good start. McCoy on the putback. And a chance at a three-point play. Givens inside. And McCoy again crashing the glass. Drexel just willing the ball into the basket. Grind it out in the half court, play solid defense, and play with the lead. And stretch the lead because of the freshman. Way outside, another challenge shot, and a big one from Dante Hill.
Drexel has played and how they are playing currently.
Fouch with the floater. Doesn't go. And the tip follow does. Once again hitting the glass hard. That guy you just saw coming in, number 24. This has not had a good day, and Lee right over the top of it. 1 point now, 3 quarters of the way through. Right. That's a brick. Baysmore uncontested for the offensive putback.
And again, using that flip chart, going after offenses.
And that is going to be, I believe, good.
Old Dominion with a little run and jump at half court, trying to trap the basketball. They want to force the tempo of the game, and look at that finish by Damian Lee. Are you kidding me?
And it's up. Macedet following the defenders in. They didn't know he was there.
Last 3 weeks, he's played his best basketball. He was injured early in the year. He's really come alive.
And that's going to count. Chance at a three-point play. All of a sudden, it's the high-flying Drexel Dragons.
Yeah, so I think they're in great condition. We've mentioned that yesterday, Scott. I really do. I think this Drexel team is really well-honed in this tournament.
That's going to fall for Cooper, and with the contact, the chance at a three-point play.
The pass goes.
That ball didn't hit the rim. The shot clock is down. Fouch knew it and hit it. There you go. That's a dagger with 3:22 to go. Drexel fans, an opportunity to celebrate right now. And what a night this will be in anticipation of tomorrow, their first CAA championship game since 2003. A dominating effort here in the semifinals and a 17-point win for the Drexel Dragons.